Hello and welcome. This is Bhaskar Napte from Pharma Growth Hub, and I welcome you all in today's discussion. We are going to talk about understanding the reportable ranges for assay and potency as per the ICH guideline Q2R2. It is about analytical method validation because range needs to be defined. And once you define the range, that talks about that your method is going to be specific, precise, accurate, and linear within the lower concentration to that higher concentration. So how one can define the reportable range for drug product assay and potency, that is going to be the point for discussion in today's video. If you look into the table number 2 that is provided in the same guidance document, right? You will find the very first point that talks about how to define the range for the assay of a drug product. And if you look into the details, there are two important columns that talks about low end of reportable range, and the second column talks about the high end of reportable range. Means low end means what should be your lower concentration to define the range. And the high end talks about what is your higher concentrations to define the range. Let us talk about the first point, that is the assay of a drug product or assay of a product. It could be API, it could be a drug product. So what is the defined low end concentration for the range now? So that starts from 80% of declared content or 80% of the lower specification acceptance criteria. Let us now decode these two important terms. The first one is the declared content. So what is the declared content talks about? Let us you have a telmisartan tablet. So what is the label claim of this tablet? That is nothing but the declared content. So we'll say, okay, 20 mg is the labeled claim. So 20 mg becomes your declared content. So what is the 20%? Then the 80% of the declared content should be your lower concentration. The 20 mg is your declared content. So 80% of this becomes your low end of the reportable range. So if I say that this stands for 100% assay. Right, this stands for the 100% assay. So what is going to be my lower concentration or the lower range? So lower range is going to become 80% of my label claim or the declared concentration. So this just become the 80% of the label claim. The second term now, if you look clearly, that talks about 80%. That talks about 80% of the lower specification acceptance criteria. Now this is little different from the first term. Now this talks about the lower specification acceptance criteria. So what is your acceptance criteria for a telmisartan tablet? Though you have the 20 mg label claim, isn't it? But every time you cannot expect that your product is always going to have the 20 mg telmisartan. And you are going to define certain specification. Let us say your specification for telmisartan assay is maybe 90% to 110%, isn't it? So now what is the lower specification in this case? The lower specification becomes the 90%. And that's the exact point we need to understand. 80% of the lower specification. So what is the 80% of the 90% now going to be? So that is going to become something, if I calculate correctly, let me do it quickly. The 80% of the 90% is going to become 72%. Is it how much it is now? It is going to become 72%. So what is going to be the lower range in this case? The lower end, I will say, lower end within the range is the 72%. So do you understand the difference between interpreting these two terms? That if you go with only the declared content, if you go with the declared content, then your lower end is going to start from 80%. But if you go with the lower specification acceptance criteria, the second point in the guideline, your lower end in the range should start from the 72%. So which one should be preferred if you have the declared content and the specification also? I think you must go with the worst case, that is the 72%. You must prefer that my lower end in the range is going to be 72% and should not be the 80%. Let us now understand the high end of reportable range. What is going to be your high end within the range study? And the first point, if you look clearly, that talks about 120% of declared content. 120% of the declared content. So what is the declared content in this same example? In this example, your declared content on the label claim is the 20 mg. And that becomes your 100%, isn't it? So 120% of that is going to define high end. High end is going to be 120%. But what about the another term that is associated with this high end reportable range that talks about 120% of the upper specification acceptance criteria. So what is the acceptance criteria for the Tell Me Certain assay? We just talked about the assay value should be in between 90% to 110%. So this is what our specification for the Tell Me Certain assay. Then 120% of the upper specification means 120% of 110% is going to become your high end concentration. So if I calculate it, let me calculate and tell you 120% of 110% is going to become, okay, let me do it once again. So my 110%, I need to calculate the 120% of that. So 110 into 120 divided by 100, that is going to give me 132%. That is what is my high end now. The high end, according to the second clause, is going to become 132%. I hope you understand the calculation of low end and high end according to the new revised ICS guideline Q2R2. So in case if you have both the details in the specification, you have the declared content and you have the specification range also. So what is going to be your high end reportable concentration? Is it 120% or is it 132%? So I will always go with the higher worst case situations, and that will be 132%. So if I study up to 132%, my 120% requirement against the declared content will always get fulfilled. So this is the way the reportable range for assay of a drug product can be defined. Let us now understand the reportable ranges for the potency. Especially the potency needs to be defined for the biological products like proteins and peptides. The potency is the measure of efficacy of the drug product. It is not the chemical assay of the drug product, but it is the efficacy, how the drug product is going to be effective in terms of delivering that biological activity is called as the drug potency. In case if you want to understand the drug product assay and drug product potency, I have prepared the video on these two terms and I will provide the link of the video in the description below. So please, in case if you're interested, click onto the link and watch that video as well. But let us now understand what is the reportable range for the potency of the drug product. So the first point is the low end. It is always lowest specification acceptance criteria minus 20%. Means if I say that my drug product assay is, or potency to be very clear now, the potency is should be, okay, let me change the color. Drug product potency should be between maybe 90% to 110%. So how much should be my lowest low end reportable, low end of the reportable range? Lowest specification minus 20%. So here is the absolute difference between the lowest spec, that is 90%, minus 20%, and that becomes 70%. So this should be my low end for the reportable range. And if I talk about the high end concentration, what should be the high end concentration? Understand here. Highest specification acceptance criteria plus 20%. So what is my highest specification here in this case? It is just the 110%. So 110% plus 20% going to become how much? Right? So my high end is going to be 110% plus this is the absolute addition, not respective percentage. So this 110% plus 20 becomes 130%. I hope you understand how to define the highest concentration and the lowest concentration for defining the reportable range according to the ICH guideline Q2R2. Thank you so much, and let me know in case if you have any question about this particular topic.